All right. Okay. Let's start, take a start from you. Wish you all of the very best luck and good luck. The first question for Tanvir is from the last 16 real interview is here. I would ask some student the first part, the second part, and some student the second part and the third part, right? Like we have three sections in the IELTS exam. Now, let's take a start. Tanvir, would you like to switch on your camera, please, if you don't mind?
Camera.
Yes. Yeah, that is also good if you have written some points for yourself. That is good. I appreciate. Yeah. Now, as far as I discussed that you candidates are supposed to write, you can see that the connectors and the transitions, like however, furthermore, in additions before appearing there in the real IELTS exam, the interview section, right? Before appearing there, 5 to 7 connectors you should write just for on the page, like to memorize it. Okay. And beside that, to talk with someone to bring a kind of fluency. Okay, let's take a start. Yes, here is it. What's your full name, please? Your camera is switched off. What's your full name, please?
My name is Tanvir Akram.
That's great. Yeah. You can also say at the examiner like this. My full name is Tanvir Akram. So you can call me Tanvir. All right. Okay. Let's, I'm just asking a few questions. Okay. I'll just like observe your pronunciation, all those things which are going to be observed in IELTS interview exam. All right. The next question for you. What kind of things make you laugh? Your camera is switched off.
Not camera is not working.
It's okay. What kind of things make you laugh?
Well, there is a lot of things which makes me laugh. For example, I can say there is a funny movies. Like funny stories or stage drama in Pakistan.
Well, that is good. Well explained. Okay, the next question for you is it important for people to laugh? Why?
Yes, it is very important. Laugh is like a medicine for people. It is strongly used nowadays laughing therapy is used for medicine and for patients to come down their stress and depression.
All right, thank you. Is trainer ma'am Umama here?
Yes, assalamu alaikum, I'm here.
Welcome, salam. I would also like to note to observe the candidates as well. Like we would give
yes,
them.
Yes, sure, yeah. I'm right here, yes.
Okay,
yes.
Okay, thank you so much. All right, the next question. Yes, please, sorry.
Sorry. Then we, you can also answer your question in a way that laughter and comedy is a lot of people are attracted to it because it's the only way of amusement these days for people, right? So a lot of things bring stress to people these days, and there's so much depression and anxiety. So laughter and comedy is one of the ways to bring down your depression and anxiety and your stress. So that's how you can answer as well.
All right, good. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah. The second question is from Parthu for Tanvi. Yeah. Talk about something you bought that was difficult to use at first. Please say, what is it? Yeah. These are like the points. When did you buy it? What does it do? Why was it difficult to use for the first time?
Well, thanks for giving me opportunity to talk about this, to discuss about this point. There is a few commodities which is hard to use initially. Although I had also these kind of things, this kind of experience in my life. I was younger boy, in age of 16. My father bought me a bike for myself. I still remember it was a red color Honda CD70. It was red in color.
Yes, thank you. That's great. The very important thing, like here, we are not going to give the opportunity to students to prepare for 1 minute. Like this was a question of cue card, where in real exam, you would be given 1 minute to prepare it. Now, if you prepare yourself it here without like making notes for 1 minute, so it would help you to speak, to prolong your answer or to speak for the enough time, right? Like for more than 2 minutes. So that's why we didn't give or don't give it here time to our students to prepare the cue card question. That was really good. The next aspirant is just let me see who is the next aspirant. Yeah, the next one is, here is it. Yeah, the next aspirant is Adnan. Adnan, are you here?
Yes, sir. I am here.
All right, Adnan. The questions for you are: would you like to show me your identity card, please? Directly starting from here.
Yes, sir. Here is my passport, and have a look on it.
Okay, that's great. Okay, just let me turn out the questions from where I can ask. Yeah, the questions for you are. Do you have shops near your house?
Yes, there are a lot of market nearby my house, a lot of cafes, a big bazaar is there, a very good and big malls are there. We are habitual to buy the things over there. People often go there to different brands for shopping or grocery and other household things, the books.
All right, that's great. That's great. Okay, the question from part two for you is, talk about a time when you have visited a crowded place. Please say what the place was, why you went there, with whom you went there, and whether or not you enjoyed your visit.
Well, I am going to tell you a place, a very fantastic place which I have visited with my friends. That is the capital of Turkey, Istanbul. Last year I was there with my friends, and we are on a picnic party, and we visited a lot of historical place of the Istanbul, like Blue Mosque, like Spice Bazaar, like Grand Bazaar, Hagia Sophia. These are the very rushy places. Especially the Spice Bazaar is a very rushy place. You know that the Istanbul is very culturally, and a lot of tourists are there, and people enjoy over there. The environment, the people, the food, the weather of the Istanbul is very good, and always there is a rush. And if you talk about the nightlife of the Istanbul, we have a cruise tour over Bosphorus River. And the cruise was full of the people.
All right. And people thank you for explanation. Mama Maima, would you like to post the comment on both of this aspirant on section two, please? Tanvir, as always.
Tanvir, you're speaking really, really well. Your pronunciation is on point. You are doing well. Your fluency is good. Also, rush is not a word. Rush is a word used in English. It means quickly, doing something quickly. If you are going to say the place was very crowded, right? And you can also say one more thing you have to do whenever you're talking or whenever you're answering. If you think that you are about to end your answer, conclude it a little properly. Okay, so that's so that okay. was the places I enjoyed very much. Okay, so conclude your answer. Okay.
Yeah, that was really great point, and really appreciate it, ma'am. Thank you so much. Like I discussed with my experience. I would just want to just share this point again. When you're done with your question, and examiner hasn't asked the next question or is not going to ask the next question, I hopefully this point will be like in your mind. That is very important. You are supposed to end this question with this point. Because of such reason, or because of such opinion, or because of this reason, I like this thing, or I'm of this opinion. Thank you. Now, this is hopefully ma'am would like it. Like, ma'am, is it a correct way to say, like, to conclude the answer? Ma'am Omama?
Yes.
Yeah. Now, this is like a formal way to give indication to an examiner to ask me the next question. Yeah, a positive way, a formal way. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Adnan. The next participant here is, let me just open the slide again. Sorry for the inconvenience. Yeah. The next participant here is Kaushalya. Hopefully, she is here from Sri Lanka. Kaushalya, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Greetings. Good night. Let's take a start with you. With your questions, yeah. How are you doing? How is the weather in Sri Lanka? Yes. Kaushalya, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. All right. She is one of the, you can say, Gen S students, like the most hard worker and my experience. Let's take a start. Do you like listening to music?
Yes.
Yes,
of course. I do love to listen to music as well. Because I'm fond of listening to music.
Mm-hmm. That's great. Yeah. You can prolong your answer as well as here and part one and part three. All right. For part two, going to part two, then some question. Yeah. All right. Describe a celebration. That is question from part two cue card. Describe a celebration you had after some achievements. Please say, what was the achievement? How did you celebrate it? Who did you celebrate it with?
Yes. Thank you for giving me this immense opportunity to talk about such an immense opportunity to talk about the celebration, which is none other than achievement which I had while I have that driving test. So. Oh my God, I can't believe at that time, since it happened a week ago. Still, I can't stop my laugh when I got surprised. I remember that day, how I got that surprise. So, however, I have been celebrated numerous occasions in my life, but among them, this day was the unforgettable day which I ever had in my life. So honestly speaking, why I'm saying that it's a miracle achievement is none other than passing my driving test. But at the meantime, my father had gifted me an own car while fulfilling my dreams since childhood as a miracle. So then, if my memories serve me well, to be honest with you, from the very beginning, the day when I was started to think about myself, I had dream about to share, have that own car. So even it's crazy though, but actually from my childhood, I'm passionate about driving. So then, was that the most celebratory occasion would I may have achieved?
All right, so thank you, Kaushalya. Ma'am, her fluency and like her consistency is very good. Besides that, she also prolonged her answer whenever I was going to ask her and even in the previous lectures. I would like to listen, Ma'am Omama, comment as trainer on her answer. Yes.
All right, Khushali, you spoke very well, and that is like you are good. Your fluency is good. You have to work a little bit on your vocabulary. Okay. Explain the way you said, oh my goodness, wow. So it's a good thing that you keep your conversation with the examiner natural and free. All right. You don't have to become stiff. It's for other students here as well. Don't become stiff. Keep yourself calm and talk freely. You don't have to use slang. Don't use slang, but you have to keep yourself calm, right? And she's good. I would suggest that you use a little bit of more vocabulary and keep your answers a bit concise, you know, to the point. Because sometimes if you are going for for a part one question, then your answer is too prolonged. But if you're going for a part two question, that answer was it was a correct one. Okay, oh, so good.
That point, I really appreciate it. Like all of the students, that is a very good point shared by ma'am. All of the students are not supposed to scare and like feel hesitation and like confidence. Examiner is not going to kill you, okay? So if you just answer in a very good way, like in an appropriate way, and follow some of these skills tricks, and like with practice, you just perform very well. All right, the last participant of mine, then ma'am, Umama would ask her participants. The last participant, let me just see. Yeah, Reina Nirwani, is she here? She's the new student. Is Reina Nirwani here?
Yes, good evening, I'm here.
Good evening. Okay, for you, I'm asking some questions from you. Can I directly start from section two, cue card?
Okay.
Yeah, okay. The question for you is, talk about a time when you had to change your plans because of the weather. Please say what your plans were, why you had to change them, what you did instead, how you felt about this.
Okay, last month, my friends and I, we planned to go for hiking. We were very excited about the plan, and we created the group on WhatsApp so that we can discuss about it. And on the eve, we were, hello?
Yes, I'm listening. Yeah, good. Yeah. Okay, carry on.
Yes. On the eve, we did a group chat. And the next day, we were all disappointed as the weather was cloudy. And it started raining cats and dogs. So we had to put off our plan. And since all my friends came at my place, so on that day, my mother prepared a nice dish for lunch and some snacks. And then we played some indoor games such as caroms and chess. And
That's great. Really appreciate it. Are you listening to me? Yes. Yeah, are you here? Sorry, 1 minute.
Yes, I'm here.
Nirwani. Okay, just want to ask you one more question, then the other experience would be asked the question, right? Sorry for the inconvenience. And the question for you is, that is from, let's take it from part three. The question is, does weather have an effect on people's behaviors?
According to me, yes. Suppose if it's raining, our mood becomes off. Suppose we have planned to go somewhere, and due to the bad weather, I think, according to me, it affects the mood of the person, because that person won't be able to go out.
Right. All right. That's great. Again, I would like to listen comment from Ma'am Umama. Yeah, as trainer, Ma'am Umama. Yes, please.
Yes. Hi. Very good. Good fluency, good vocabulary, good precision. You were concise, to the point. That's that was a good attempt. Yes.
Yeah, thank you. That's great. Okay. Now it is time to Ma'am Umama. She is going to ask her candidates. Yeah, I hopefully this list would be with you. But let me just share again for you. That is here. Yes, it is here. You can ask your participants from Abina. Is Abina here? Is she present today? Is Abina present?
Abina is not here, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay, let's move on to Darshani. Darshani, are you here?
1 minute, sorry for the inconvenience. Darshani was actually the new, now 1 minute. Let me just see. All right, just let's ask the remaining two participants. Hopefully they will be here. And then we would move to the some other new participants. You can ask them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Maya.
Yes. Good evening.
Yeah. Maya.
Yeah.
Good evening. How are you doing, Maya?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good. Okay. So Maya, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. All right. I will ask you a question from part one. Right?
Okay.
So do you live in an apartment or a house?
Well, I live in an apartment in Abu Dhabi. And it's a city.
Right. Explain, tell me about your apartment then.
Okay. It's a two-bedroom apartment with a living room, kitchen and balcony. Actually, I have one master bedroom. And the other one is without attached toilet.
All right, good. So describe your favorite room of your apartment. Which room do you like the most in your home?
Mostly, most of my time I stay in my living room. So I prefer to stay more also because of there is a TV and there is a bookshelf in my living room. So I prefer to stay in my living room.
Great. That was a good attempt. And what do you think that what do people look for when they are choosing a home? When people have to choose a home, what do they look for usually?
Usually, people have different taste. So for me, I think the safe place they will choose, of course. If they stay with their family, then calm and quiet place and spacious apartments.
Great. That's good. That was your third answer was very good. Properly on the point, but make sure you conclude it, okay? For example, you first said the security of the house is necessary, where the place is. If you are living with a family, it should be a nice and quiet place and with a good neighborhood, and it should be spacious to meet the required wants. So that these are the things that I would look for when I'm looking for a home. That's how you end the answer. So so you have to give a cue to the examiner that you are done with the answer. Okay. So good attempt. Good. Okay. So the next one, who is next?
Is it me?
Yes, Sandeep is next. Right. How are you doing, Sandeep?
I'm fine. I'm good. How are you doing?
Good. Wait a minute, Sandeep. Mohsen, would you like to comment on Maya's answers?
Yeah, she was a bit fluent, but I think she need more vocabularies and
more vocabulary.
Like tenses.
Okay.
She need more tense sentence. She have imagination, but don't know to make a. Sentence.
So she had to prolong her answer, but I guess it was okay. Good. Thank you. All right. So Sandeep, I'm going to ask you a question for a part three. Okay. So can
Let
you
me
tell
see the question.
Me?
Okay.
How can people innovate or make new discoveries? how can people come up with new things?
Yeah, thank you for the question. In my imagination, what I felt in making a new thoughts on discovering a perspective on new technologies, basically might be on whatever basis. The first thing is that the people or a group of initiatives should plan for a group discussion. They might be want to make one thought on imagination, what they want to explore on. When the exploration overs, they need to talk on their personal participations and do something like marketing call, what the review of changing the world into present scenarios, and come go to the, I mean, to say it, what's the advantage of this? Doing it, basically,
right, thank you, Sandeep. Okay, next question. Okay,
sure.
At what age do children learn to form their own opinions and make decisions? What age do you think children become able to think about their own opinions and decisions?
I think psychology has said that nurture is greater than nurture. It means that nurture means a time where children born and they grow up till 10. The age between 1 to 10 is the most important to build up. Yeah.
That's a good answer. That's a good answer. Okay. How about and who do you think helps them in making those opinions or making those decisions?
Yeah, basically I have said nurture is greater than nurture. The parents is the only one. They think of, they grow up, what they see, that they speak up. The parents is the one, the teacher, and it comes about the teachers, that is known as God. Yeah.
Yes, good. So the teachers can influence their decisions, their parents, their siblings, their household, their friends. So to be honest, Sandeep, I have a 1.5-year-old daughter and she makes her own decisions. Do you know that?
Oh, yeah.
Right? So yeah, she makes her own decisions that she wants to eat cookies. She does not want to eat vegetables, right? So children from a very start, from the beginning, they make their own decisions. You can nurture them, of course, you can guide them, but in the end, it's their own abilities
perspectives,
to
understand.
Yes. That's a good way. Good, Sandeep, good. Sandeep, you can you have to conclude your answers a little bit, okay? The second question was not a little concluded properly. So your vocabulary is very good. Your grammar structure is also very good. Yes. Sir Mohsen, would you like to ask something? Okay, I guess he is not here. So about the other candidates.
Sorry, my mic was unmute. I was saying, like, if he also used the connectors, the transitions, so you can also beautify the answer and can get 7.5 plus.
Course, yes,
good, yeah, good, and good. The last point was also appreciated. To use to conclude the answer in a good way. Okay.
Yes. Okay, so if Abina or Darshani or one of them is here, so we can talk to them as well.
Hopefully Abina is here from iPhone. Is Abina here? iPhone, who is from iPhone? She mostly joined from iPhone ID. Abina, who is from iPhone? Okay, let them ask if someone else wants to participate. Otherwise, please, someone wants to participate.
We can talk about more things. We can talk about points that we should be focusing on.
Yeah, the new aspirants have joined for the demo session. If someone has any query regarding speaking module, they can ask regarding speaking module, or regarding IELTS. Abina is here. Yeah, Abina would like to participate. She is here. Abina, would you like to unmute your mic?
Yes,
Abina, ma'am would ask easy question from you.
Abina, I'm here. It's all right, we can participate. Hello? I think she's having a connectivity issue.
Maybe. I think she has left. Yeah. No, she has not left. Abina, I think you are audible. Hello? Yeah, you are audible. Yes. Hello. Yes, yeah. Please.
No, I'm having.
Yeah, you are audible. Yes, ma'am.
I was like to ask. Gary, in the network was very poor.
Hello. Hello. Are you here? Hello.